Hey everyone, Digital David here. Today in this video, I'm gonna be checking out the Yeedi C12 Pro Plus. This is a robot vacuum cleaner and mop with bagless self-empty station. So it's got a bagless container that can last up to 7 weeks. Yeedi is sponsoring today's video, but I do want you to know that any opinion expressed in this video is strictly my own. That being said, if you're interested in this product or you want to find out more about it, the link to it will be in the video description. Here's a look at the retail box and packaging. Now let's go ahead, let's open it up and see what's inside. Here are all the contents. First up, we have our product literature consisting of our instruction manual, compliance information, and 1-year warranty info. Underneath, we have the base plate for our auto empty base. We have an extra mop pad, side cleaning brush. We have our Osmo Mega mopping system with mop pad already installed. We have the vacuum and we have the auto empty base with bagless design. Let's look at the vacuum and base in more detail. Looking at the top of the vacuum first, you'll notice the Yeedi logo and branding on top of the LiDAR navigation module, 3 control buttons, and we have a removable magnetic cover, revealing our dustbin that we can remove as needed. Filter cleaning instructions right there. We can pop this open to get access inside if we ever have to manually empty or clean. And we can swap the filter as well. This is where the contents are gonna be vacuumed out. And there's a look inside with the dustbin removed, QR code for setup, then it just snaps right back in place. You also notice the Wi-Fi indicator light right there under the cover as well. Looking at the side, starting in the front, we have our array of sensors along the navigational bumper. Those continue on both sides of the unit. Making our way towards the back, we have our dust outlet, charging contacts, and removable vacuum module right here. Take a look at that. That's where we can install our vibrating mopping module. It'll just slide and it'll click right in place just like that. And it let us know that it switched to vacuum and mop mode. Moving right along, you'll see the sensors again, and then we're back to the front. Now looking at the bottom, you'll notice our 2 spring-loaded drive wheels, our main cleaning brush and roller. So take a look, we have different types of bristles. We got harder bristles there, softer bristles here. This is removable so we can easily clean, replace, and maintain as needed, and then everything just snaps right back in place. Love the red color scheme and accents we have all throughout. Omnidirectional wheel up at the top, cliff sensors, and then we can take the included side cleaning brush and just snap that right in place on our vacuum. And now you're looking at the mopping module from the bottom with it installed, and you get a feel for how much contact this pad's gonna be able to make with your floors. Moving right along to the auto empty base. On the top, you'll notice we have 1 red button and handle to release for our bagless dust bin. Here's a close up of that bin, and we have our max indicator front and center on it. And you can see the other side right here with our lock and unlock indicator. And to release the dustbin, just go ahead, grab, press, and it will release. And you can empty out all the contents and get access to cleaning it out as needed. You can follow the instructions and notes right there as well. And again, lock or unlock, so we can just gently move this to the unlock position, just like so, to take that off to get access to our filters for additional deep cleaning. And here's your look at the base with that removed to get a feel for the different channels that it uses to self-empty. Here's your left side profile. Here's your right side profile. Here's a look at the very back with our on and off switch, integrated power cord and cable, additional product info, and some venting right here. Here's a look at the bottom of the unit, 4 grip feet and 2 slots to attach the included base plate that'll just line up and fit right in place. And looking at the front of the unit, you'll notice the Yeedi logo and branding, indicator light, charging contacts, and self-empty. With that transparent dustbin design, you have a real-time visual indicator letting you know how full the vacuum station is getting. And to show you how simple installation is, literally just line up the base plate and set the auto station on it just like that. Plug it in, power on the switch, and you're all set and ready to go. look at the results after our first clean. Starting with the RoboVac, you'll notice your typical human hair collecting on the side cleaning brush. So just make sure every once in a while you're turning this over to properly maintain and detangle as needed. The main brush roller definitely overachieved in my opinion. I see a couple of threads here from our shag rug, but I really don't see a lot of human hair tangled here, or even pet hair for that matter. Just a couple of those longer threads from our rugs. Most of the hair actually got stuck right there. But again, very common, and I'd say with this design, it's actually overachieved, and we don't have as many tangles as I was expecting. And then looking at the mop pad, we got a thread here, some dirt there, little piece of grass here or there. We also have a couple of pieces of this black material. That's actually from a mat on my floor that I use for my standing desk just to provide me with some extra cushion. So little pieces of that have collected on the mop. Just a reminder that you're gonna wanna take this mop pad off and rinse it down after every clean would be ideal, just to keep it as fresh as possible, but so far so good. Moving along to the dustbin right here, it conducted a self-empty already since we can see the contents in our bagless design. So I thought we'd look at the dustbin itself to see how good of a job it did, and it emptied everything flawlessly. There's nothing left over. I see just a couple of crumbs at the bottom, a couple of fibers of hair. That's it. The filter looks as good as new still too. So did a great job there. Also wanted to show you the base plate. That looks brand new still. You might notice a wetter spot here depending on how long the mop has been sitting, but nothing has built up or transferred or any sort of residue on this. Moving right along, let's look at the dustbin here. Plenty of space still for tons and tons and tons of cleans before we'd have to empty this thing. We have one wad of hair in there from our first vacuum, and I can already see some crumbs and stuff collecting on the bottom here. So let's go ahead and let's empty it out. We can look at everything in more detail there. Give you a close up of the inside now that it's empty, fairly clean still. And then you'll notice in here the wad of pet hair and human hair, and then tons of crumbs and household debris, what you'd expect to find when vacuuming. We're just left with one question to ask. How does the C12 stack up against the competition? Let's go ahead and take a look. We'll be comparing it to the over 60 plus robot vacuum cleaners that we've encountered across all different brands, price points, and feature sets. That'll give us a great baseline of what you could expect from a typical robot vacuum to see if the C12 is at or exceeds the average robot vacuum cleaner available today. First up, we're looking at max suction power. This is measured in PAs. The C12 comes in at 8,000 PAs compared to your typical average of 5,000. So pretty substantial boost of 3,000 PAs of suction power in favor of our C12. Next, we're looking at max CFM. Typically, you want to see higher suction power and higher CFM. They usually go hand in hand, but it's not always the case. But in this case, you'll notice we have the higher suction power and we have higher CFM, both above average. So in this case, almost 3 CFM more than your typical robot vacuum cleaner. What does all that extra measurable performance get us in real world deep cleaning? Well, using our own test where we embed coffee grounds into carpet and vacuum it before and after, you'll notice that the C12 got a fantastic score of 95 out of 100. So 10 points above your typical average RoboVac. In regards to decibels, this is how loud the vacuum is. So the lower this value, the quieter your vacuum will be. We always test this vacuuming on carpet with max suction power and carpet boost settings enabled. In this case, we're 9 decibels above the average. But I really want to point out that you're not really going to notice much of a difference between a robot vacuum vacuuming your house at 70 decibels versus 79. They're both going to be noticeable. In regards to battery life, Yeedi claims up to 300 minutes. That's going to be on your lowest power setting and everything enabled to maximize that runtime. Your typical average is 150. I think realistically, you'll see around that, maybe 180 or so, give or take, depending on the suction settings you're actually using for this vacuum. But either way, it's definitely gonna be above average. One reason we get such great battery life is our above average battery capacity. You'll notice it's almost 2000 milliamp hours more than your typical RoboVac, but you need all that power and juice for the increased suction power and its mopping capabilities. In regards to height, height, this is measured in inches, very standard here with the C12 at 3.8. Typically you find that 3.8 to 4 inch mark for LiDAR equipped vacuums. Our average is actually lower because we review quite a few robot vacuums that don't have LiDAR, so they have inferior navigation systems. Now they are more budget friendly, but without that module up top, they can be a little bit shorter to get under some furniture that maybe this vacuum can't. In regards to our dustbin capacity, this is measured in milliliters, 400 milliliter dustbin compared to the average of 420. That's actually really good considering the fact that self-empty vacuums like the C12 usually have smaller dustbins because they don't need the larger bin because they can empty themselves. Whereas if you don't have a self-emptying vacuum, you usually find larger dustbins built in to prevent you from having to make as many trips. So we're just about at that average, but that average doesn't always have self-emptying capability. So it's great to see that we get the larger dustbin and still have self-empty. Same thing can be said for water tank capacity. If you have a fancy enough RoboVac that supports the ability to refill itself, you tend to have a lower capacity water tank. In this case though, we're near the average, just slightly below by about 15 milliliters. But I do want to point out the C12 does not support the ability to refill, wash, dry, clean itself, any of that. So you would want to see this usually be 235 or above. We're close enough, it's not that big of a deal, but again, the larger capacity just means you're refilling that water tank less. Added bonus, don't forget that this unit is a bagless self-empty, which is fantastic. As I inventoried all of the models that we've tested, only about 5% have this feature. Just recently, a couple have came into the studio, but usually before the last month or so, we'd only see Shark branded vacuums have this feature. So it's great to see it trickle down to other brands like Yeedi and Eureka currently have them as well. That just means that you're saving more money each month, not having to buy new vacuum bags for your station. Also, the C12 is equipped with a vibrating mopping module. This does a really good job cleaning compared to your typical just static mops that drag on the back. Obviously, having vibration or any sort of oscillation or revolving mop pads definitely makes a difference on how effectively they're going to be able to clean. And in this case, this mop does a great job with that vibrating module. So last but definitely not least, let's talk about cost. So you'll notice that the C12 Pro Plus is a couple hundred dollars less than your typical average robot vacuum cleaner. But for all the metrics and performance that we just looked at, we're getting above average cleaning results and feature set with the bagless design, vibrating mop pad, self-empty, substantial value to be had here with the C12 Pro Plus compared to the competition. Now, let me give you a brief overview of the Yeedi app, specifically for our C12 Pro Plus. This is the main device screen and menu right here where we can quickly start a clean, send it back home to recharge, or enter in to view our map and more additional cleaning settings. So take a look at our map right here. I haven't customized it or done anything yet besides add one no-go zone. Up at the top, we can tidy up some of these rooms too. We can merge them all together. They are part of the same room. All of that can be accomplished. Up at the top, we have this map editing icon in the center of the three icons where we can view our saved maps. This does support multiple maps. So we can edit our map that's in use here. We can add virtual boundaries. So we can set those up here if you want to add just a wall or if you want to do a box. So you can set that up. That's going to be for no vacuuming. This one's going to be for no mopping. You have both of those options available right there. Next, we can redivide rooms or combine rooms as well. So very easy to customize. You'll also notice at the top we have our settings icon here where we can see all of our device settings from our cleaning log to scheduling a clean, when it's time to conduct maintenance on certain parts and components, all of that broken out for us right there. Sequence settings, you can set a cleaning sequence if you want. We have intelligent settings here, auto empty as well as suction boost on carpet. Up to you how you want to configure that. We also have more settings here if you want to set do not disturb or child lock. Auto resume, definitely recommend turning that one on. Language options, we can learn more about the robot, help section, and we can find our robot if it's missing around the house. Back on the map, you'll notice towards the bottom, we have three different tabs. We can do an auto clean, room clean, or zone clean, and we can add up to 5 zones at one time. We also have our station settings here where we can empty the dustbin. And then if we go to our clean down here, we can slide that up, swipe it up, and then we have our different suction settings. We have our water flow settings, vibration frequency, up to you if you want to adjust that, and then different cleaning passes. Do you want it to clean one or two times? So that's how we can customize and control all of our vacuum settings and preferences within the Yeedi app for our C12 Pro Plus. Very convenient, straightforward, simple layout so you can find exactly what you're looking for. So we know the value's there with the C12 Pro Plus, but let me share with you a couple final thoughts. The biggest hurdle for me with this vacuum is the fact that I have to swap out the mopping pad and module for the regular module when I want to vacuum my carpets or rugs. I really wish we had the option within the app to leave the mopping module on and just be okay with it going over our rugs or carpets. I don't want to have to swap and manage that all the time. And there's no built-in storage for this vacuum piece at the bottom. So it's just kind of cumbersome and bulky to have around. So I wish that they would adjust the base station to have storage for those accessories and give us a software update so we could just leave the mopping module on and it could go vacuum over carpets and rugs. Again, only if we agree to it. I know some of you out there don't want to have that wet mop pad making contact with your rugs or carpets, but for me, I don't care. I'd rather have that than the hassle of each time swapping between the two. If that's important to you, you should check out our review of the M12 Pro Plus, where that's not an issue. Other than that, I had higher expectations for the obstacle avoidance. It really seemed to struggle with a lot of larger items, so good luck with anything that's really small. But again, maybe in the future that can be changed. But again, when we look at it from the cost perspective and value, it's on par and still exceeds what the competition will give you at this form factor and price point. So overall, really well done with just a couple of quirks that personally I'd like to see changed. I also thought it was important to mention that the C12 Pro Plus is a part of a larger C12 family. We have the C12 and the C12 Plus as well. You can see a quick comparison and breakdown between all three products, with the C12 being your most affordable entry-level option into the C12 family, followed by the C12 Plus, which bridges the gap between the C12 and the C12 Pro Plus. The C12 Plus consists of that same great bagless self-empty station, building upon the features of the C12, and then lastly the C12 Pro Plus, which we covered in this video, builds upon the success of the C12 Plus by adding that vibrating mopping module.